Hi, in the previous episode, I redesigned the MSPC motherboard. Now expansion cards are mounted on the board a little bit differently than in the release one. So I have to redesign my expansion cards also. Let's start with VGA card. Additionally, RP2350 supports external PS RAM with memory mapping. This feature is useful for frame buffer implementation. I have to fit the whole board on a really small PCB board, 24 by 50 mm. That's much smaller than for MSPC version 1. However, using RP2350, I can use only a single MCU instead of two of them, significantly reducing the required space. For the RP2350 design, you can check the previous video, linked above. The VGA card doesn't have its own power section. Power is delivered by bus connector. There is an 8-bit bus between the motherboard and the VGA card. I wired only one QSPI slot due to a lack of free GPIO and space constraints. So I am going to use RP2354 with flash memory on board. But until it's available, I should be able to test the design with just PSRAM module, loading firmware to SRAM memory at each startup of my graphic card. Then I wire both the DVI output and the VGA, which use the RGB 332 signal, which is 8-bit. For VGA, I've created resistors digital analog converter. Let me briefly explain how it works. Firstly, we need to know how VGA signal is defined. VGA uses two signals for frame synchronization. Horizontal synchronization signal basically says next line, next line, next line, which tells the screen to move to the next row of pixels. Vertical synchronization says next frame, next frame, next frame, so tells the screen to move to the first row. There are also defined timings for the blanking region and synchronization pulses, but let's skip them right now. This will be needed when I will be implementing a VGA signal generator. In horizontal lines, frame pixels are transmitted using three analog signals, defining red, green, and blue colors according to the pixel clock. The voltage level between 0 and 0.7 volts carry information on how bright a given color is. But MCU works in digital domain. That's why I need converter to translate signal defined by 8 pins, at which I'm going to output pixel signal, to analog domain, which is task for digital to analog converter. Let's check inside simulation how that converter works. Basically, it's register ladder with well-calculated values. So for example, for red color, which uses 3 bits, I can output nearly linear 8 color levels. Same for the green color. Since I have only 8 bits, blue color is less accurate and contains only 4 levels. I also added ICE2C for display information reading. Displays use 5 volt and RP2350 3.3. So I designed a simple voltage level converter using MOSFETs. My new board is too small to fit both VGA and DVI connectors. So my plan is to make DVI as an attachable part above the VGA port. Fitting all components in such a small space was really challenging. But my board finally looks like that. It's a really simple board, so it doesn't contain many components. But to fit them all, I had to place them on both sides. I really can't wait for the RP2350 to arrive. But in the meantime, I'm still working on my Raspberry Pico simulation inside Renode. That's all for today. See you soon in an episode about the creation of the expansion card with FPGA chip. Bye!